Usually, people get frightened when they hear the word intuition. They start thinking, oh, I'm bringing some religious concept. No. Understand the intuition in a very simple way. For example, you are hearing a calling bell in your house. Suddenly you remember some friend's name whom you have not seen for many years. When you go and open the door, he is there. And when a cell phone rings, you remember somebody's name, some friend's name. When you answer, he is there on the line. And in the party, suddenly you remember, you feel the same thing has happened in your life earlier. And somebody is going to come, some particular person is going to come there. After a few minutes, you will see that you will be coming. How many have you experienced something like this at least once in your life? More than 70%. If it happens once in one person's life, we can say it is a coincidence. When it happens in so many persons' lives, how can we say it is a coincidence? Surely it is not coincidence. There is a logic behind it. We need to understand something more about it. In the planet Earth, there can be nothing called coincidence. Everything is only cause and effect. When we don't know the cause for the effect, we call it as a coincidence or miracle. Actually, there is nothing called miracle. Everything is very clear. Everything happens only based on cause and effect relationship. When we don't know the cause, or when we are not able to find the cause, we say it is a miracle. What you experience in these moments is what I call intuition. How this happens? Knowingly, unknowingly, you infuse silence into your unconsciousness. For a few moments, for no reason, you become silent. You give a little bit of rest to your unconscious zone. Then suddenly, intuition comes up. Intuition can happen to every human being. And it is just one more dimension which we have not explored. In the modern day, the intuitive management idea has become very popular. When intuition happens to you, not only you will have a clear decisions, you will have enough of courage and power to execute the decision. As of now, any decision made by us only makes us tired. One more thing. If your mind is restless, even if you don't do any work, just sit in your chair and be restless for half an hour, you will have shoulder pain. After half an hour, you will have shoulder pain. More restless, you create more diseases for yourself, and naturally our decisions will be unconscious without any logical end or without any profit. When you infuse silence into the unconscious zone, you go up to the level of intellect first. Means you become more logical, more peaceful, relaxed. If you infuse more silence into the unconscious zone, when all the entrants are erased or removed, naturally you start receiving intuition. You become more blissful, more active. I have seen some people, 24 hours they will work and then they will be alive, active, vibrant, because they work from intuition. They don't work from instinct. If you are working from instinct, 5-6 hours is enough, you will be tired. If you are working from intellect, maybe 10 hours, you will be tired. If you are working from intuition, 24 hours and something more, you will be alive and vibrant. Because you don't waste your time unnecessarily in the unconscious engrams. Our time is not wasted. Our minds don't have to go through so many tables. Unconscious engrams. When you go through every unconscious engram, the file is distorted little bit, twisted little bit. By the time the file takes a quantum leap and comes out, totally it is distorted file, a distorted decision. which we don't even know why we are executing it, why we take the decision. These are the few answers. Again, I'll just give the summary. While any information which you receive through eyes or any senses, over the DSP, digital signal processor, inside your being, and then the whole file gets converted into digital signal, goes to memory for initial processing of excluding. Then it goes to mind for identifying. Then the whole file takes a quantum leap through the unconscious engrams, and the ego decides what to do, and your body executes. Here the important thing, the more number of engrams in the unconscious zone, more you will be restless and more you will work based on the instinct level, and naturally you will be prey for every emotion. And the moment you start infusing silence in the unconscious zone, you come up to the level of intellect. You cannot be exploited by greed and fear. No opponent can outsmart you. You will be equal. But the moment you come to the level of intuition, by infusing more silence into your unconsciousness, not only you will be able to work 24 hours, you will be naturally outsmarting the opponent. Because everybody is working, playing with mind. They are working, they are living their life based on reactive mind. When you go to the level of intuition, you can just outsmart them because you know how the reactive mind works. And you can simply outsmart them. Infusing silence into your unconsciousness is what I call meditation. The more you infuse silence into your unconsciousness, the more you become intuitive and simply you can outsmart your opponent. These are the few concepts I wanted to present. Now we can analyze this concept and internalize them through question answers. You are welcome to put any question. I'll try to respond to this. Yes. Two ways I can define. Space of discontinuity and space where the decisions get distorted. For example, you went to vacation, your big vacation, and then you had some bad experience. Next time, the moment you hear the word vacation, the whole memory will come into your mind. And you will decide just illogical decision. You will just shout at your kid, why are you always talking about vacation? Don't you have any other work? Who won't do your job? For no reason. You can see in your life, just for no reason, you become angry. You just get mad at people. Actually, logically, if you see, nothing will happen in that situation. But the past memory associated with that words, with that ideas, just comes up, erupts out, without even your knowledge, and tortures you. One more thing, even when no file comes from outside, when you are sitting silently also, these engrams are so powerful, they come out and disturb you, puts you into depression, restlessness, and uneasy feeling, feeling disturbed. All these things are because these engrams comes up without even any file going from outside. If you are just sitting also, they just erupt and create some conflict within yourself.
Suppose I go with a prepared mind, upset, good meat and living, by the action of the will, it's going to be different. If I say, in the normal circumstances, I know that you are my friend, I know I'm going to be that friend, or I'm going to be a friend, then my friendness is going to be different.
One small thing, I wanted to bring it to your notice, that is outsmarting and outwinning. Outwinning is silent, outsmarting is very relaxed.
Yes, that's right.
Outsmarting is nowhere violent.
No, it's not. I'm not going.
And you are not even going with an idea to win him. Winning him is different. Outsmarting is totally different. By outsmarting, you can help him. You will also be helped and you can help him with your conclusions and decisions. Outwinning means you will be putting him down and you will be winning the whole situation. But here, when I say outsmarting, win-win, not winning and losing, win-win situation. Yes. Dr. Charles Towns, who is a Nobel Prize winner in San Jose, which university?
Berkeley, Swami.
Berkeley University.
University of California.
He was telling me, he has discovered laser and maser. And he said, Swamiji, it came just as a revelation. And it is not an intellectual conclusion. And I had a big trouble to create steps for my conclusion. Because I know the conclusion, but I don't know the logical step, what to do. And he says, after having that revelation, it took many days for him to create a logical step and present it to the world. Because when you present it to the world, you need a logical step. So, he says, it is a complete revelation or intuition. Yes, please.
So, you have your plan of action, you go to the battlefield, you spread the last words. I thought that we have to do that kind of mind. You'll be able to turn out days and days of work.
Exactly. Infusing silence into your unconsciousness. When you infuse silence into your unconsciousness, all your preoccupied decisions or ideas, preconceived ideas, it disappears. See, there's two things. One thing, collecting all the arguments and passing judgment. Another one is creating your judgment and collecting arguments to support your judgment. There are two things. Usually, when we are restless, we have our judgment. And we collect arguments to support our judgment. But when we infuse silence into our consciousness, we become logical or clear. We start collecting arguments and passing judgment. What he says is really wonderful truth. When you go without any preoccupied idea, really, you do much more than what you are expected to do. And he said one more thing. The outsmarting opponent word has got some violence. I do agree. I am sorry for it. And one more thing, after all, I am relating with the people who are working with reactive mind. So I have to use some term. I have to use some term which gives, creates an interest in them. Which creates an interest in them. So that is the reason I use that word. But that's the reason I tried my best. It should not be violent also. That's why instead of outwitting, I use the word outsmarting. Yes, I agree with it. Here I differ with you, sir. Here I wanted to say an important thing. The idea of meditation has been, the very word makes us feel it is complicated because we are not given our right techniques. It's like we always work with the wrong techniques. That is the reason we think meditation is very complication or it's a very complicated process. Actually, when we can, if we can work with the right technique, if we can enter into the right technique, simply infusing silence can be achieved by overnight. We won't need, I think, full night. And if you feel it's like a too good to be true, you should forgive me. But it is true. I'm working with millions of people all over the world. From that experience, I tell you, infusing silence into your consciousness is not as difficult as you think. It is meditation. It is easier than you think.
Okay, that's the case. Let's say I start meditating.
Okay,
I started meditating. So
how
am I going to get
that
$1 million?
Now, one thing. You see, the idea of meditation means not concentrating on suppressing your mind. Entering into awareness means just become a witness for all your thought. If you have the thought that $1 million, when will I have the $1 million? Neither suppress the thought nor go behind the thought. Usually when we get the thought, we do two things. Either we go behind the thought, we start working for it. Or we suppress the thought. Both will create engram in you. For half an hour, just witness the thought. Every day you can always take half an hour. Half an hour is not a big thing. You always say, oh no, Swamiji, half an hour is too much time. When you can spend so much of time to take care of your body, why don't you spend at least 20 minutes or half an hour to take care of your mind? And one more thing, you don't even need separate time. When you are driving, you can just sit. And you can drive and just what? Witness your thoughts. When you are driving, when you are sitting, when you are eating, just witness your thoughts. Instead of going behind them or suppressing them. Usually we do these two things only. If we think it is possible by us, if we have confidence, we start going behind the thought, working it. If we don't have enough confidence, we suppress the thought. Don't do both. Just witness. Take few minutes. Just see. Just like how you watch TV. Just witness. Allow the thoughts to move into your consciousness. You will see. You will be infusing silence into your being. Meditation does not mean concentration. When you have the idea, meditation is concentration. Only then you try to silence your mind. You think no thought should come. Meditation is not like concentration or suppressing your thoughts. It's like allowing your mind to settle down, infusing silence into your unconscious soul. So you don't have to suppress your mind, control your mind to meditate. Just witness automatically what I say, that silence will happen to your unconsciousness. It will be infused into your unconsciousness.